Hello, my friends. Good evening. Look at the color of the sky. Color of the sky, color of rainbow. Day after plus 27. 27 days since the abolition of the state of emergency Serbia. Today we had no casualties as far as the COVID-19 is concerned. And we had 69 new cases of discovered infected patients, but we are testing something. I don't know today, but yesterday it was 4,500. So still, although 69 compared to yesterday's 24 may seem a bit high, but this is still, I would say that we are quite okay. What happened on today's date? I read again this the source of mine for this section of my videos, let's say. The Parliament of Montenegro voted the separation of Montenegro from Serbia. So this was the final act of the country known as Socialist Federative Republic of Yugoslavia falling apart. So from that moment, all six ex-republics of the why did I go this way? Now I'm quite puzzled. Okay, never mind. So all six republics were separated into individual countries in 2006, and prior to that, in 1999, Kosovo was not a republic in ex-Yugoslavia, so it was the autonomous region within Serbia. There were two autonomous regions within Serbia. Vojvodina and Kosovo, but interestingly, there were no autonomous regions within other five republics. So this was quite tricky, actually, because allegedly because the Albanians were not considered as constitutive nation of Yugoslavia, whereas, for instance, in Croatia, with huge number of Serbs living there, historically there was a region called Krajina, which was historically practically belonging to Serbs. It was not the case. That they got the autonomous region of Krajina because the Serbs were practically constitutive nation of the Yugoslavia, and hence there was no need for that. The explanation for Vojvodina was a bit different because there were so many. Vojvodina is such a mixture of various nationalities, of course with the Serbs being majority, but again there were so many that I believe there are 27 nationalities in Vojvodina. So, yeah, okay, that much about politics. Now, my opinion of, especially when talking about Serbia, because the country practically fell apart in 1991 with the first separation of Slovenia, which went relatively easy with some, it was a 10 days, some military conflict. But then they were, because they were quite clean as far as the minorities are concerned. Although there are quite a number of Bosnians living in Slovenia. But anyhow, they are considered quite clean. Because historically there were no, but Bosnians were coming only to work in Slovenia mostly. And presumably they are still going there to work. then it happened with Croatia, etc., etc. So, okay, the rest republics stayed, and then Bosnia also exploded. So there was now practically Serbia, Montenegro and Macedonia. And then even the Macedonians decided to go away on their own. And at the end, practically after the year 1992, I believe there was a country called Savezna Republika Jugoslavia, meaning the Federative Republic of Yugoslavia, consisting only of two countries, Serbia and Montenegro. And then at some stage, this name has also been changed to the name of Serbia and Montenegro. And it happened, I mean, this was the case up until 2006, I mean, this day, 3rd of June, when also Montenegro decided to go on their, I mean, Montenegrins decided to go on their own. It was relatively tight, I mean, the voting. But yeah, the majority prevailed. My personal feelings about that, not much has changed. Okay, the Montenegrins, they changed their currency to euro from Yugoslav dinar. I did not go that often to Montenegro. When I was a kid, we were taking our, I mean, we were taking our, spending our summer holidays mostly in at the Adriatic coast or in Greece. More, it was more at the Adriatic coast, but more to the north. I mean, the Croatia, the most frequent was Rovinj. Back then it was not as posh as it is today, I mean Rovinj. But also we've been to Dubrovnik, the island of Hvar, where else, let me just think, Split, I believe. And then only once we went to, if I'm not mistaken, to Montenegro, to Herceg Novi and Igalo. But this was mostly because my mother was suffering back then from some problems with her back, and the Igalo was allegedly good for that. There was some mud therapy there, and this was the reason why we went to Montenegro. And this did not go quite well, because we had some stomach issues, spoiled stomach, etc., etc. So, all in all, yeah. And then I went once, and twice actually, once with my elementary school to Buljarice, and once with some friends of mine from, twice actually, once with the friends of mine from the high school, once when I was already a student, and then once with some friends of mine after I finished my university studies. And then after this last one, let's say, happened in 1998, the three of us went there. Back then all three of us were practically assistant professors at the Belgrade University Faculty of Economy. And then I stopped, and privately I only went last year. Not last year, but 2 years ago. 2 years ago, sorry for this. but only not for a summer holiday, only for around the 1st of May, I mean for a week essentially. But prior to that I went 3 times for business reasons, 2 times to Budva and once to Podgorica. And that was it, I mean, my stays in Montenegro. It's nice, I mean, especially now that I went the last time with my family. It was quite nice, I visited some places that I didn't visit before. And yeah, the nature is spectacular, but yeah. Yeah, definitely the nature is spectacular there. For the rest, yeah, food is also good. I mean, in some places, practically great. But I mean, I don't mind that we are two separate countries. I mean, this is what I practically wanted to say. They wanted to be on their own, which is okay. And that's it. Okay, that much for now. I'm now trying to find some place. So thank you for watching and bye for now.